Welcome back to Computer Vision. Today we're going to be learning about a technique that is important in general, but we sort of slid it here, and we're talking about recognition under the generative model description. So last time we introduced, which I hope for you was last time, certainly for me it was last time. They say you never forget your first time. Me, I can barely remember the last time. Last time we introduced generative models for classification. And there were a couple of points about generative models. Megan's still giggling in the back there. One of the points was that in generative models, you build a new model for every new object category. And you don't really think too much about the other objects that you know about. And you just you build a description. And when new things come in, you see how likely is the new thing for each of the description, each of the models that you have. But there was another point, and that was perhaps a little more subtle because it was kind of flew by. And that is that generative models work best in lower dimensional spaces. And what I mean by that is, since we're going to build these probabilistic descriptions, usually some sort of probability density function, it's only plausible to estimate those when you've got a modest number of dimensions. If you have a very high number of dimensions, or even just a moderate number of dimensions, to estimate a real probability density requires lots and lots and lots of data. So today, what we're going to do is we're going to learn about one of the most common and perhaps, I don't want to call it important, but just everybody would expect that you would understand it, method of dimensionality reduction, which is referred to as principal component analysis. You may have seen this in other signal stuff or maybe in linear algebra, but it became pretty significant in computer vision because of a particular piece of work that I'll tell you about, and it because of that, it gets used all the time.